Hello everyone, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today's tutorial is a style that I saw on Instagram. It was a more bridal type style, but I think this would be so fun to wear for any occasion, even if it's just, say, a girl's night out. So let me know what you think down in the comments section. Make sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss any future videos, and let's get started. For today's tutorial, I'm going to be doing two Dutch braids along the top of my head. So since I want them to be about the same size, I'm going to have my part slightly off center. I just prefer this over a direct center part. So starting on the right side, I'm going to pick up a small section of hair to use for my braid, and I am leaving out some hair to frame my face. So this section is next to the part line, about an inch or so back from the hairline. And I'm going to divide it into three smaller pieces. And since I'm doing a Dutch braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands under the middle strand. And as I go, I'm also going to be incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. I'm only going to bring in about three sections on both sides of the braid, one side from right along the part line and the other side from directly under the braid. I want to leave out most of the hair on the sides of my head because I'll be using that hair later on for a different part of the hairstyle. So once I've brought in my sections, I'm going to stop adding in additional pieces and just braid the section a little further down. Then I'm going to go back over the braid and carefully pull on the sides so the braid is wider and looks bigger. Then I'm just going to slide a couple bobby pins over the bottom so it doesn't come loose. Now I'm going to repeat the same steps with the hair on the left side of my part line. So I'm picking up a section about an inch or two back from the hairline, and I'm going to braid a Dutch braid along the top of my head next to the part. So I'm just crossing the side strands under the middle strand, and as I go, I'm also going to be incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. And I'm going to be bringing in about three or four sections, one side from right along the part line and the other side from directly under the braid. I want to leave out most of the hair on the sides of my head, working my way along the top of my head. And then I'm just going to braid the hair down a little ways without adding in any additional pieces. And then I'm just going to go back over the sides and pull on them carefully to make the braid wider. And then, of course, slide a bobby pin over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now that the two braids are done, I'm going to pin them against my head. So I'm going to lay the right braid over the left and pin the braids in place. I like to slide my bobby pins into the middle of the braid, grabbing only a few hairs with each bobby pin, and then slide them upwards along the braid so they're hidden underneath the hair. I slid a couple into the center of the crossed braids, one on the top part of the left braid and the bottom, and another on the bottom of the right braid. A good rule of thumb is to pin wherever you're holding the braids, and I just keep pinning until they feel nice and secure and aren't going to fall loose. So once that's done, I'm going to remove the bobby pins that were at the ends of the braids and then unravel them up to where they're pinned. So now I'm going to divide off a small section of hair on the right side of my head next to the braid, and I'm going to twist this section upwards and then add in a couple more pieces of hair as I twist it towards the back of my head. I'm going to go back over the twist and pull on a few pieces so the twist is fuller. This will help make the twists look bigger, and it will also help hide any part lines that are underneath the twist. And then I'm just going to lay it over the braids and pin it on the left side. Hi, Dad. Then I'm going to take a similar sized section on the left side of my head,
twist it upwards and add in some additional hair as I twist it back towards the back of my head. And then to make the twists bigger, I'm going to carefully pull on the edges, of course. And then I'm going to lay it underneath the first twist and pin it on the right side. So I'm just sliding a bobby pin into the twist so the hair stays in place, but the bobby pin will be hidden underneath the hair. And now I'm going to divide off a small section of hair underneath the braids and twists, and I'm going to use this to create a topsy tail. So I'm going to wrap a clear elastic band over the section. And then I'm going to create a gap in the hair above the elastic and flip the hair around the elastic band to create two twisted side sections. Then I'm going to gently pull on small pieces of the twists so they're 2 to 3 times bigger. I pull on the sides as well as in the center of the twists. I literally pull the hair back out of the elastic, so don't be afraid to pull the hair a lot. If it becomes too much or gets too big, you can always take the elastic out and redo it again. It won't unravel the whole hairstyle if you have to do that. So once I like the way that it looks, I'm going to wrap a section of hair around the elastic band. So I'm just going to divide off a small section of hair and wrap it around the elastic band about 3 times. And then I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the wrapped hair so the elastic is going into the bobby pin. And this will hold the wrapped hair in place while making sure the bobby pin will also stay in. And then I'm just going to go back over the wrapped piece and pull on it so that it's as big as the twists above it. This will add another dimension to the hairstyle while hiding the elastic band at the same time.
That wraps up today's tutorial. Be sure to let me know what you think of this hairstyle down below in the comments section, and make sure to click the thumbs up or the thumbs down if you want to see more half-up hairstyles. Be sure to click the notification bell as well so you never miss any future uploads, and I will see you next time.